definitely is today's job, guys. The old kitchen doorway can come out now. And boarded over, I think, because the original glass was broken from the 70s. But we'll take this piece of ply off and get the frame out. I'm going to two these halves out. Now I've got the new kitchen extension on the bike. I've got some of those original bricks left, so they're not an ideal match. They're 65mm, the new bricks, and these are slightly bigger, so the gauge on the joints is slightly more than what the original ones are. This one here is a bit all over the place. There's a different colour marker there, so it looks to have they put a black dye with this and then just gone back to ordinary sand and cement. You see the difference in the two colours. But the gauge is slightly out with the new bricks, but we've managed with the extension. So first job is I'm going to rip the old door out, and then we'll start tooling out with the new bricks to go in. Time to get the mixer out, guys. I don't think you've seen the inside of the garage yet. That's where the mixer is. Yeah, there's the mixer. It's a while since I've used it now. It's your truss roof. Workbench. Bikes. Decent engine hoist. That's the other room in there, the workshop. Other stuff at the moment. Let's get the mixer out. Oh yeah, there's always a television if you get bored. Bifolding doors are in now, guys. Well, I've got the outer piece of plywood off. It's just covering up the original 70s door. Two panes of glass, single glazed. It's just been boarded over and plastered on the inside. But this is the original frame that's been put in. And the way you can tell, you see the snots of mortar is the joint.
and you've got the snuts and mortar that when the brick's been put on, the mortar and brick been tapped down, the mortar's spewed out at the end and fill the joint up between the frame and the brickwork. So this is the original frame. What will have happened is that the frame will have been put in position once we've got the damp-proof course in, and a plank rested from the top down to the ground with possibly a couple of blocks on to hold it in position, and then the brickwork, instead of having to plumb this side up, the bricks have just been butted up to the edge of the frame. Same on this side. I haven't taken the master copy out of this one, but this will have been the same. So the frame's been put in, and then the brickwork's been built up around it. There is a catnick lintel over the top, which is unusual. Quite often in the 70s, they didn't bother with the catnick on the outside. They just built the brickwork on top of the frame and put a timber lintel on the inside for the blockwork. But that has got a catnick in, so it's unusual. But I think that helps us. But the mortar is extremely hard here, so a small span like that, you'd doubt it, but you get any brickwork dropping down. Maybe on the larger windows you would do, but yeah, there's quite a lot of cement in that mortar. Well, we've got one side chewed out now. Struggling a bit because the mortar's harder than the bricks. And I think they've just chipped one of the bricks at the bottom, but the other halves have come out okay without too much damage. It's one reason why you don't have the mortar harder than the bricks. I've just got the other side to do, and I've got a mix on, bit of damp proof course at the bottom, and hopefully we'll get the outside skin in today.